just had me fall down.
Down in front, please.
Hey, do not yell at anybody.
Where's your man?
I can't see him at all. Can you?
Tell him that I want to take a picture of the Irish.
Some mishaps at even today's happy ceremony.
You have to do the old chair trick. They're not embarrassed in Irish.
We want to do the chair trick, but we don't want to do it to a
President, do you still want military aid for the conference?
Party.
Okay, let's go.
We have guests today from the land of ancestors of maybe a third of all Americans. And let me introduce a few of them. The ambassador from Ireland, His Excellency Patrick McCann. Before she vanishes from our sight, let us welcome back to the United States for the moment our ambassadress to Ireland, Margaret Heckler. A gentleman who honors us by his presence with us from near Donegal, head of the Socialist Labour Party, Dennis Haughey, and welcome. Friend, the Embassy Councillor Martin Byrd, we are delighted to have you. Our guest of honor, from whom we shall hear a bit in a moment, representing His Excellency the President of Ireland and the Minister for the Environment, Patrick Flynn. Now, I want to claim the privilege of two toasts and then for response that they may feel. Friends, be recognized. First toast, of course, is to His Excellency the President of Ireland and to the wonderful people of that wonderful land. This is the eighth time, I think, that the President of the United States has honored us on St. Patrick's Day with his presence. Late years, Mr. President, we have buried all difficulties that might exist between political parties and branches of government on the the day of St. Patrick. You know more of movies than I do, but I remember a movie, and when I think of you, Mr. President, sometimes I think of that wonderful movie filmed in Ireland, Quiet Man, in which John Wayne and Victor McLaughlin argued and fought and scrambled against one another for several reasons, until finally they found a begrudging mutual admiration and at least became brothers-in-law. The film does not record that they didn't quarrel anymore, but I like to think of that happy moment. And Mr. President, on this occasion that was begun by my predecessor, Tip O'Neill, and which we observe each year, and which you honored and graced with your presence, I've got a toast that I wrote to you today. To his lilting spirit and his winsome way with words, to his personal courage that has triumphed over physical travail, to his genes, keep him young and give to the rest of us hope, to his good humor and the good luck that attend him as the legacy of his ancestors, and to a future filled with joy and hope and health and opportunities for service, for Ronald Wilson Reagan. Seamus Wright.
I'll keep this brief on St. Patrick's Day. You should spend time with saints and scholars. So, of course, you see, you know I have two more stops I have to make. I turn back to the ancient days of Ireland to find a suitable toast, and I think I have found it. St. Patrick was a gentleman through strategy and stealth, drove all the snakes from Ireland. Here's toasting to yourself. But not too many toastings, lest you lose yourself and them. Forget the good St. Patrick and see all those snakes you get. I believe that, that those who love us love us. But those who don't love us, let God turn their hearts. And if he won't turn their hearts, let him turn their ankles, so we'll know them by their limp. May you have warm words on a cold evening, and a full moon on a dark night, and a smooth road all our days.
Okay, thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.